Yeah, hello guys. In case you're fond of cycling, in case you're a cyclist or you want to improve your efficiency at cycling, I have a wonderful thing for you. It's called a foam roller. You shall always do few foam roller exercises before cycling or after cycling. Me being a cyclist myself, I do these foam roller exercises on a weekly basis. So I'll show you a few of them which will help you to cycle and will help you to cycle without any, you know, you will not be putting much of energy into it while cycling. You will not be exhausted after cycling in case you do this. First thing. Second important thing is it will keep you safe from the injuries also. A knee injury or an ankle injury or a hip or a back injury, you will be safe in case you are doing these foam roller exercises. Come, join me. Take a look what and how the foam roller has to be done correctly. This is my foam roller. First and foremost is the ITB or the outer part of the thigh which shall be released. For this, you need to keep the roller under the thigh, the shoulder. The elbow has to be just beneath the shoulder and you are just going to roll up and down. While doing this, you might feel some knots, some trigger points, some hardness area, whatever it is, you need to stay there. Stay there, breathe in and breathe out and focus on that area. It might take 30 seconds, it might take 20 seconds or it might take a minute for that area to get released. First is the this is the first stage of foam rolling, or you can say the easiest stage of foam rolling. Next important thing is what you can try giving some movement to that area. You can try your rolling and you're bending the knee. You're rolling and you're bending the knee. That is the second stage of foam rolling where it will release the tissues further, but it's going to be painful. In fact, it's painful for me also. Third important thing is once you have mastered this, you have covered the whole lateral aspect of the thigh, you can keep the other leg onto the leg underneath and give it some movement along with rolling. No doubt it's very painful. Ouch! Ouch! But it helps. It helps a lot. You can try tilting the pelvis also in front and backwards along with rolling. Make sure you need to go very slow. The faster you go, the more ineffective it is. You need to go very slow. Feel the point, let the foam roller go into your muscles and deep into the tissues. Go closer to the knee, as much as, and then you need to slide up, go closer to the knee, bend your knees, let the weight of the upper leg lie on the leg beneath so that you get a good amount of pressure. Next important thing for this sort of rolling is you are not supposed to go beyond the area of this bone. There's a bone here. You are not supposed to roll on this. You are going to roll from this area till the knee and it has to be soft. Coming to the next important foam rolling exercise, for especially for cyclists, you need to sit onto the roller. Bend one of the legs, tilt your body and take the knee down. So my right hand is actually closer to the roller, my left hand is little away from the roller and I am trying to take the knee towards the ground. So it will be somewhat near the lateral part of the sacrum which is going to get the maximum pressure. Then again, you know, you can try locating the trigger point, as I mentioned earlier, the hardness area or any area where you feel the pressure is maximum. let's see. For me, it is this point. So you need to just stay there for a while. Stay there, breathe in and breathe out. Again, 30 seconds to 1 minute, or maybe 1.5 minutes. And let the area soften. Feel it. As you might get a feeling as if the area is, you know, melting. The more focused you are, the more amount of breath you can take there, the more melting of the fascia will take place. Even if you don't understand these medical terms, the best thing is you just need to stay focused and feel the pressure on your butt, especially the outer part of your butt, to be specific. Third roller, which is again going to be very helpful for cyclists, is the front thigh roll. I'm coming into the third form of rolling now. You need to lie onto the roller with the thigh and with the roller underneath. I'm keeping my thighs in. Make sure you're not straining much of your butts, your shoulders. Make sure your tummy is not sagging in. Your feet are relaxed. You know, I'm not tightening the feet like this or this. I'm keeping them relaxed. And then gently I'm going up and down. The best way to foam roll is just choose an area of 4 inches. Foam roll there. As and when you are able to, you know, lessen the stiffness and the hardness there, just switch over to the next 4 inches. I have switched over to the next 4 inches now. I'm again, you know, trying to locate the hardness. Then, this is the second stage now. You can add some bit of movement to it. In case you have not tried the first stage, don't progress to the third stage. Next, third stage of foam rolling would be for the thigh, front thigh. You can keep one of the legs onto the other leg. Since I have to face the camera, so I'm turning my neck. But for you guys, you need to be, you know, just looking down. Look down onto the floor and foam roll. Oof, and focus there. Ouch, I'm getting a nice this thing now, stretch. I've kept the one leg above the other leg, and then I'm giving the movement of the knee also along with the rolling. It's awesome. It'll increase your efficiency at cycling. Coming out of the roll now. Hope you guys enjoyed the video, and in case just give it a try, and maybe in the comment section you can comment, did it help you, how much it helped you, or any problem you found with that. And before I stop the video, there is one thing I'd like to mention. Maybe your muscles might get sore, it might be tender after 6 to 8 hours. Nothing to worry, it'll go off of its own. Or else you can apply some cold pack there for the first 24 hours. In case it still persists, go for the hot pack. Good luck. Happy rolling.